Nice. Seems like I've got a real talent for this.
Rat blinks.
Thank you. The squirrel's nose twitched.
Garbage.
Thank you.
Be wary. The urns will shatter. The bones will rise.
The glowing corpse looks to you. The erratic rising and falling of its sternum is accompanied by melodramatic gurgles.
Come. Come to me.
The creature murmurs a series of unfamiliar noises that amount to absolutely nothing. The creature groans unpleasantly. You see an undead figure chained to a torture rack, bones glowing a sickly green, as if lit from within. It raises its head to look at you before lowering it again, exhausted from the effort.
Please, release me! Mordus, the priest, not what he claims to be. Without me, he is nothing. A worm, a grub. He doesn't draw upon his own strength, his own source. With this contraption, he draws upon mine. Free me! Release me from Mordus' torture! Not dead, yet not alive!
It goes silent, save a slight wheeze with every rise and fall of its bony chest.
The fiend is gone then. Oh, glory to the stars! My soul! No longer his to imprison. The panel, please.
The skeleton ekes out a crackling moan.
The panel. Seven bless you.
Thank you. Garbage.
About time, too! I can't tell you how long Mordus has been draining me. I'm absolutely famished for sauce and sinew.
The creature harumphs.
You free the master of the magical arts. For that, I'll leave you alive and untasted. For demolishing Mordus's minions, I'll give you a skill book of your choice. Choose your subject. I offer you life and learning, and you're still begging for more? You're wasting my time. Here, just take a book. Its wisdom might do you some good. Speaking of which, allow me to share some wisdom of my own.
The undead creature bears two rows of broken, cratered teeth.
Stay out of my way. Curse you, Mordus, and curse your blasted machine.
The creature begged for release, but can it be trusted?
We're pretty formidable these days. Might as well hunt that thing down before it causes too much trouble.
I say we hunt it down. Sometimes it's fun to play the hero.
He who wakes an ancient evil must slay said ancient evil. If that's not an expression, it should be.
Thank you. keeping it together, Bree.
Glad to see you well. Anything more?
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Well, don't come over. It's not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tun, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Until later, then.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't... You needing supplies? With anything more?
How are you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Until later, then.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Over here
than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Well, don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
They don't come visit your tongue. Who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Glad to see you well. Anything more? Until later, then.
The carved figure is of your touch.
Smells worse over here.
Hero, I'm grateful.
A sense of urgency from deep within you quickens your heart and hardens your gut. Your god wants you to know that this sorcerer can help you on your mission. She can help you to become more powerful.
What news of Gwydion Rintz? Have you found him? My hero, I'm grateful. What news of Gwydion?
The bitter air warms, your eyes close.
Thank you.
have a duty. Gather more source and complete the ritual.
You suck the smoke deep into your lungs as the world fades away.
Yeah. My champion! You've come not a moment too soon. It's here! Even here! We must hurry now. We must race toward the well with all the determination of the eagle diving for its prey. Your prey lies on a far-off shore, at the heart of the Nameless Isle. It is a place no one can reach unless their soul becomes their compass.
He places a hand over your heart, and you suddenly feel it, an unmistakable pull in a new and distant direction.
The battle for divinity is about to begin in earnest. The other gods and their chosen will try to outflank us, just like we must outflank them.
But I will be with you. I will guide you, stand by you. I will watch as you drink from the wellspring and as its source surges into you.
The void will be overcome, and you will be the god of gods. The end is nigh. Don't fail us now.
You jolt back to the world, stumbling forward. Dark smoke surrounds you, hanging in the air like black fog. This feels wrong. The Meister's cry cuts through the haze. You look up just in time to see what steps out of the shadows. Your god told you there can be only one. He said you'll eventually need to turn on each other.
Like I'd ever listen to some spook at the peril of my friends. Not in this lifetime.
A girl's best friend is her needle. But I'll stick by you as long as you continue to uphold your particular brand of useful.
I've use for neither gods nor men. I myself am the island that is my destination. You, a mere port along the way, I tolerate. For the time being.
Seems to be the code to a safe. Better hang on to this.
Voidwalker! Damnable, bloody Voidwalker!
Well, that's that. I always knew I'd die for Rivalon. I just didn't expect it was going to be in a small basement. In Driftwood, of all places. At least now you know where to go. I was dying anyway. The Magister's purging made certain of that. I should probably send the Void a thank you bouquet. At least they were efficient about it. No. Today my death is not important. All that matters is that you find Malady and tell her the location of the Council. Just be wary. She is immensely powerful, and she is on our side. But she will not be pleased about, well, my parting. She may ask you to honor an old bargain that I had struck with her. Do not accept. Her business is with me, and me alone.
She glances at her body once more, a grim look on her face.
You need to go, Godwoken. But I have one last request. My last wish, as it were. I want a statue. Something modest. A simple piece of marble and gold on the steps of the cathedral, glaring out over Arx.
Meister Siva's shoulders slump, a tired, melancholic grin on her muzzle.
Oh, I would have liked to see that city again. Just once more. Give them hell, Godwoken.
Don't come over! Not like you're buying anything.
The carved figure is at your touch,
Wouldn't you like to know?
It does not respond to my touch. There must be a way to activate it.
Thank you.
The creature devours the corpses as a vulture devours carrion, stopping only as you approach.
I have my freedom. You have your reward. Do you not recall my warning?
He drained me.
Let me feed. Oh, I cannot control the hunger. The world won't mourn a few meatbags for long. I must be free of Mordus. He might cloak himself in skin, but his innards still rot. Rip away his hide, and he's a mere grub. Yet he's also a conduit to the void, a mouse with the power of a mountain. My source was his lifeblood. Now my hunger must be sated. My soul will be mine again. My soul jar waits in the hills. Each taste of living source is like a healing salve. When I am full, I can finally open the reliquary that holds it.
The creature continues its banquet. Blood spurts spray from the victim's flesh like lava from a volcano. The beast gorges on its meal. A sleuth of bears would make less of a bloody mess.
Well, look at you, all noble. I can't promise that your sacrifice will fill my belly. But if it sates me, I won't seek more.
It reaches out with its brittle fingers, and you hesitantly offer your hand. In an instant that feels like an eon, your source flows into the famished creature.
Oh, refreshed and refilled. Oh, you won't need to worry about your precious innocence anymore. Join me at my reliquary. I will take my soul. You will take what remains. The creature rubs its clattering hands together. It's about time. My soul rests inside the reliquary. I need but a drop of your blood to open it. I am Zash! It's about time. My soul rests inside the reliquary. I need but a drop of your blood to open it. I am me. I am whole. I am Zash! It's about time.
Thank you.